Next up, we have Eyal Ronen, how to not share a password.
You're not supposed to have the device.
I'm kind of ready to fight. Okay, I want to use this special occasion for a really, really big announcement. I want to tell you all that passwords are finally dead. Woo! Woo! I'm not talking at the previous time when Bill Gates said it, or when Google claimed it, or all of the other previous times. This time I want to tell them they're really, really dead, pushing up daisies, and I can't really do it. The reason is that passwords are not dead. They are widely used today, and they're going to be widely used tomorrow. And today we're all talking about IoTs and stuff like that. They all use passwords. They are here to stay for the near future. So instead, we want to try to find a way to use them a bit more securely. And what our paper is how to not share a password. And what we want to say is that basically, if in the past, if you had a bad password, you would compromise your information, your data. Today, bad passwords, and we've seen it in the IoT world, in the Mirai deck, can be used to create large botnets to attack the entire ecosystem, the whole internet, and we need to find a solution to that problem. And there's a big question, who is liable in this situation? Is it the users that chose the bad password, or is it the manufacturers that allow them to do this? And we believe that the manufacturers should have some kind of liability, they should do things better. Okay, so there's many possible solutions for the password problem. We've seen the NIST guidelines, for example. We've seen the NIST changing the guidelines multiple times, last time a few months ago. And I don't think that there is any cure them all answer. Most of the solutions are snake oil. But we want to suggest a specific solution to a specific problem. We want to blacklist popular passwords. We don't want an attacker to be able to use a relatively small number of passwords and try them on a lot of different devices, for example, web-connected cameras, and be able to create this large botnet and attack everybody. So we have one main problem with this, is that we don't really know the password distribution, and we claim that the password distribution may change over time. For example, this is due to the famous NIST guidelines. The passwords are becoming more complex and more secure. Then they are telling to be simpler and, by NIST definition, more secure. And we all know that Superman was a very popular password in the past. We believe that Wonder Woman is becoming more and more popular right now. There are different populations based on age, location, that may choose different passwords, and there are sometimes really, really weird stuff that just pop out of the air. We want to be able to detect those weird things. Okay, so when we try to do things with passwords, the first one to do is we don't want to do almost anyhow. And if we publish a blacklist of popular passwords, then the attacker will know those are the popular passwords. You can try to use them. So first we claim we are basically doing something that's similar to publishing a code vulnerability. We're going to tell the people, look, these passwords are weak. Everybody uses them. You shouldn't do it. If they're still continuing to do it, if they're not going to patch themselves, then they're going to get hurt, but we're going to save the entire ecosystem, which we like the ecosystem where we live in. And if we want to learn statistics about passwords, we need to learn some information about them. So we need to help the privacy of the user's password, but we're going to do it just a little bit, and in the paper we prove that it doesn't help them really, really bad. So basically what we want to do, we want to identify the blacklist, those popular passwords. This is similar to the heavy eater, privately learning heavy eaters problem. And we want to make sure that the server doesn't learn a lot about each user's password. We want to, if possible, not miss any of the popular passwords. We want to block them all. But if some non-popular password gets blocked, it's not so bad. So a user will need to choose another password. Okay, there are a lot of previous works in the privately finding aggregators and other settings for more specific to passwords. And the main difference is that our work assume very bad stuff, meaning that the world is a malicious world. Everybody is trying to get us, and the malicious server will want to learn more information about the passwords. And if we already have a attacker that controls a large portion of our users, they might try to attack and subvert this protocol, try to hide the popular password, because if you have a popular password, it makes their attack easier. So everybody are malicious, we want to be able to handle that. And we actually have something that handles it. It's relatively efficient. We can show it's relevant to the IoT world and certainly for the PC world. And we feel this solution might be also used in other settings. For example, getting statistics on the Tor network, learning the distribution of smartphones PIN or patterns, and allowing large service providers to learn the actual distribution of the user's password in a very secure way. The paper is online in print. If there is a large service or small service provider here that wants to use our POC, we would be glad to do it. And I will try to handle the other 27 seconds that I have killed because I really want to fight some of this. And thank you very much.